शांति ओम भूर्भुवत्सुव तत्सवितर्वरेण्यं भर्गो देवस्य धीमहि धियो यो न प्रचोदयात्। ओम भूर्भुवत्सुव तत्सवितर्वरेण्यं भर्गो देवस्य धीमहि धियो यो न प्रचोदयात्। वी मेडिटेट अपॉन द एडरेबल एफलजेंस ऑफ द रिस्प्लेंडेंट विविड फायर सविता, मे ही स्टिमुलेट आवर इंटेलेक्ट। वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग डियर फ्रेंड्स, वी मस्ट स्टिमुलेट आवर इंटेलिजेंस, वी मस्ट बी वाइज टू अटेन पीस एंड हैप्पीनेस इन दिस लाइफ। And for this, the soul should be enlightened, the Saptgun Sampanna soul. And there can be no other teacher than the most successful person on earth. And who can be better than Kautilya or Chanakya? So let's see some of his ideas and thoughts which can really illuminate us, enlighten us, and make a person who can deal with the problems of this life very happily and satisfactorily. Do not be very upright in your dealings, for you'd see by going to the forest that straight trees are cut down while the crooked ones are left standing. A person should not be too honest. Straight trees are cut first and honest people are screwed first. We must be very wise. It doesn't mean that our heart should not be very pure. It should not be very truthful, or we should not be selfless. Simply, we have to use our wits and intelligence in the right proportion, because this earth is not an abode for only the enlightened and wise person who thinks Vasudev Kutumbakam or Sarve Bhavantu Sukhina. There are people who are very selfish. So we have to deal with them very intelligently and wisely. But I suggest all my friends, there should not be any compromise on character and values, because this is the most precious thing on earth. There is no substitute for character. There is no substitute for values, honesty and integrity. That has to be attained at all cost. We should never be following anything which can make us a sinner on this earth. The serpent, the king, the tiger, the stinging wasp, the small child, the dog owned by other people, and the fool, these seven ought not to be awakened from sleep, because this is inviting problems. If we deal with people who are ignorant, whose soul is not enlightened, they will bring only misery, grief and sorrow. They are just surviving beasts. They are two-legged animals. Beware of these people whose soul is totally in the darkness, in the gloom of ignorance, and they have overnight in their life. The happiness and the peace attained by those satisfied by the nectar of spiritual tranquility is not attained by greedy persons restlessly moving here and there. Be spiritual, understand the very philosophy of life, enjoy every moment of your life in doing noble work. Kavya Shastra, Binodeno Kalo Gachati Dhimatam Vasanena Cha Murkhanam Nindriya Kalhenva. Learn, educate, enlighten, spread the flame of light of wisdom here and there, everywhere, wherever you go. Go with the kingdom of your wisdom. That ultimate wisdom is love everyone, forgive the sinner, and maintain your calm, cool, tranquil state in every circumstances. He who lives in our mind is near, though he may actually be far away from us. But he who is not in our heart, he is far, though he may really be nearby. It is not a matter of distance, it is a matter of place in the heart. The ultimate source of energy, the limitless the omnipresent and omnipotent, we cannot see him physically, but because of our great love for this Almighty Father, any serene people will always feel his presence, who is always sitting in his bosom and helping him to live a very peaceful and happy life. Do not keep company with a fool, for as well as you can see, he is a two-legged beast. Like an unseen thorn, he pierces the heart with his sharp words. These are very cruel people. Their heart is filled with jealousy, hatred, envy, and their words are like hidden knives thirsting for blood. Beware of these kind of ignorant souls. They can ruin your peace of life. Purity of speech, of the mind, of the senses, and that of compassionate heart are needed by one who desires to rise to the divine platform. There should be a place where free from all kind of impurities, only then it can offer a throne to the most blissful Lord, who can make us peaceful and happy in life and work every time to make other people very happy and prosperous. Let not a single day pass without our learning a verse, half a verse, or a fourth of it, or even one letter of it, nor without attending to charity, study, and other pious activities. One whose knowledge is confined to books and whose wealth is in the possession of others can use neither his knowledge nor wealth when he needs for them in their personal life. We should not fret for what is past, nor should be anxious about the future. Men of discernment deal only with the present moment. He who is overtly attached to his family members experiences fear and sorrow, for the root of all grief is attachment. Thus one should discard attachment to be happy. We remember Buddha, he also told that the root cause of suffering is desires. So we only aspire to do some noble things in the interest of the mankind. And detach yourself. Detachment, that can also save us from suffering and tortures. We must understand the philosophy of life. This life is a journey. It is journey that's most important. The end is inevitable. So we should play the role. As Shakespeare told, the world is a platform and we are all actors. So we should be very careful that whatever role we have been offered to play, play like a valiant person, a fearless person, because we know a valiant tests death but once, but a coward dies many times in their life. Be fearless. The root cause of sin in life is to be fearful, and you will be always fearful when you are crossing the Lakshman Rekha, because everyone has got a very well behaved train to experience in life. That is, we have to be pure, truthful and selfless. As long as we confine ourselves to these boundaries, there is no power above the sun or below the sun which can really harm us and which really can ruin our peace and happiness in life. Om Shanti. Om Shanti. Om Shanti.